Hey guys, thanks for checking us out here at Media Unlocked. My name's Eric, and today we're gonna be talking about how to take your glide cam or your steady cam and achieve what we call low mode. Now the idea behind low mode is being able to get a smooth tracking shot with the camera as close to the ground as possible. So here we have our glide cam set up traditionally how you would if you were going to be shooting with it normally. So our cable to the camera, we have it taped off at the handle so that it's not going to be putting a lot of tension on your connection into the camera. And then down here at the bottom we have the rest of the access cables wrapped around the base of the monitor. I also want to point out the placement of our weights on our sled. We have pretty much all the weights on the back, and we're using our monitor as more of a counterbalance to our glide cam. This is a handy technique to use if you're shooting with a heavy lens and you don't have enough weights to counterbalance your glide cam. Now, when we go into low mode, we're gonna wanna have more weight above the gimbal with the camera than we do below the gimbal. Now, if you have a glide cam system that has a fixed gimbal, this is gonna be a little bit more challenging. One thing that we've done is that we went ahead and put more weights up here at the top with the camera, just duct taped it to the camera mounting platform. So that's an option for you if you have a fixed gimbal. The cool thing about the Kovacam K500, which is what we're using here, is that the gimbal can adjust. And what we're gonna do here is we're just gonna adjust this, loosen it up and bring it all the way down. And then we're gonna just start fine tuning our balancing from here. So I'll pull this out here in front. So moving the gimbal down to the base is already gonna flip, put all the weight up towards the camera and basically invert our shot. The problems that this causes is that sometimes your weights will, if they're not secured properly, will pretty much just slip off. So what we're gonna do here for this test is we're gonna take our weights, we're actually going to reposition them on the top, which isn't gonna change the weight proportion, but it's gonna keep the weights from falling off and messing up everything. So, the other thing we gotta do is we have to flip our camera, our monitor around so that we can see it. So we're gonna loosen our monitor up, we're gonna turn it upright. In this case, something like this, so we can actually see it. And then our next step is to just balance like we would usually. So here on the Kovacam, we have a couple different dials on the camera mounting platform, and we're just gonna start shifting them around. As you can see here, we have the camera successfully inverted, and the biggest thing for us, the easiest thing for us was that the gimbal was adjustable. So if you're going out and you're gonna be buying a glide cam system, make sure that it has an adjustable gimbal. It'll make everything pretty easy for you. If you guys don't have an adjustable gimbal, you just need to add a lot more weight to the top of the camera and take off your weight from the bottom, and it'll basically flip this. Now, what we have to do in post is we're gonna have to flip our footage because all of our footage is gonna be upside down. So that's an easy step. It doesn't take a lot, and yeah, so that's basically how you achieve low mode or getting low tracking shots with your glide cam and inverting your system to adapt to that. Hopefully this video was helpful for you glide cammers out there. Thanks for checking us out here at Media Unlocked. Please leave a comment below and share this with any of your glide cam friends if they're having trouble achieving low mode or low tracking shots. But yeah, check out our blogs at MediaUnlocked.net and subscribe on our YouTube channel. We'll see you guys next time.